Hey everyone, and welcome to the Dota 2 Builds of the Week, the weekly series where I show you guys top 5 meta builds to help you get started with new heroes in Dota 2. As always, a link to all the builds are in the description down below, as is a link to my Twitch if you want to catch the action live. This week, we're starting with Position 1 Wraith King. Wraith King is seeing a lot of play in the professional DPC season, and what you're seeing is a balance between essentially building survivability on Wraith King, but also providing him with a lot of one-shot capabilities. With regards to the builds, I'm actually going to still maintain the concept of, especially for relatively new players, I do like the idea of including both a Radiance build and the Armlet Midas build for those that are interested. Wraith King has two major builds that most people go for. The first is to go to Radiance, which is kind of less common right now, but still, if you're a relatively new player, it's worth checking out. Basically, you build your Gloves of Haste so you can kind of farm faster into a Radiance. Now, it is a long haul to the Radiance, but once you get it, you get a very early, like 17 to 19 minute timing. It becomes very difficult for the opposite team to kind of contend with you. And then you go into a Desolator, which makes your right clicks do devastating amount of damage. You go a Blink Dagger so that you can kind of get on top of them and hit them very effectively, because the major problem with Wraith King is he can be kited very easily, which is the reason why you take the movement speed so that you can kind of stay on top of them. Alternatively, you can go into Midas, into the Armlet of Mortar Gideon, and the reason for this is because what you're going to do is you're going to go Midas, which kind of is a slower, kind of weaker item, but it allows you to get really greedy, especially for lower MMR games, into Midas, Deso, which makes your right clicks absolutely insane, and from there, Blink BKB like the others. Regardless, Wraith King is seeing a lot of play in the current meta, and if you are interested in learning him from scratch, I do have a complete beginner's guide video for him that I'll link up above to help you get started. I love the DPC Pro season because with it comes mid-Doom. While Doom is traditionally played as an offlane position 3, pros tend to be playing him as a mid. And what's amazing about this is that once you take his Devour and you start building a net worth advantage, at about level 8 you'll start rotating into other lanes with your Doom and basically securing kills on major enemy targets. The build is a build that is very kind of, it's unique in the sense that it is different than the offlane Doom. The reason for this is because you're taking Doom at level 8. Not at level 6. You can take it at 6 if you wish, but the way the build is generally working right now is you're focusing on maxing Devour first so you can kind of get more gold faster to kind of snowball your net worth advantage. You're taking Scorched Earth so you can kind of really push waves and kind of take the small camp on your mid side there. And you're taking Doom at 8 because at about that point in time you're strong enough to be a legitimate kill threat. So then at level 8, because you have a level advantage, you can then rotate into other lanes using Scorched Earth and actually start devastating opposing enemies. So that is the theory behind mid Doom. You can still take Doom at 6 if you wish, but this is kind of the primary thought process. You are going bottle into Midas. The Midas is it is greedy, but with Doom, right, you're going to build such a huge net worth advantage with Devour and Midas that it ultimately doesn't matter, because Midas, although is a slow item, with Devour, Doom is able to get it with tremendous efficiency. From there, the build is like stock at like in almost all levels. You are going Phase Boots into BKB, into Blink Dagger. The reason for this is you're going to try and pick up a very useful stun from one of the neutral creeps using Devour. You're going to blink on them. You're going to stun. You're going to Infernal Blade. You're going to Shiva's Guard. And then, of course, the Refresher Orb into Doom. Ultimately, Doom mid is a very interesting hero, a great option, and also one that you can be playing in the offlane if you choose. You couldn't believe my excitement when I saw Underlord being once again played in the pro meta. Underlord's one of those heroes that, quite frankly, does not get a lot of play in the pro metas. He is a notorious beginner-friendly hero and one that some people find a little boring to play. But for me, he's one of my absolute favorite offlaners, and if you're new to Dota 2, he is the penultimate offlaner to kind of learn from scratch while you get used to the game. Now, with that being said, the buildup is kind of consistent throughout almost all games. What you're doing here is you're taking a lot of regeneration. He is tanky, but he's also very slow, lunky, and vulnerable in the laning stage. I do like the fairy fire into double tangos, healing salve. You just want to have a presence in lane. You're going to be rushing a Vanguard early, taking the Ring of Health. You could even do Ring of Health first into Soul Ring and then finish the Vanguard. And then you're taking your Boots of Speed into Arcane Boots. From there, you have a choice to make. You can you can finish your Vanguard into a Crimson Guard if the other team has lots of right-click, or you can build a Hood of Defiance into Pipe of Insight if they have lots of magic damage that would benefit your team if they had resistance. You can also, again, with this, not build the pipe and just go the Hood of Defiance, which is beneficial for you as well. One of the items that most people sleep on with Underlord is the Aghanim Shard. The Aghanim Shard allows you to self-cast it, so it follows you around. It also reduces the cooldown, and that's important because with the cooldown reduction talent at 15 and the radius talent at 10 and the percentage burn damage at 20, Firestorm has 100% uptime and becomes essentially a complete nightmare to deal with in high ground scenarios, in pushing scenarios, in team fights as it follows you around, especially if you're building very tanky items. From there, I do love finishing the Arcane Boots into Guardian Greaves. It basically makes you borderline unkillable and really helps your team overall with its Guardian Aura, and then finally getting an AC to help with the final push at the end. Underlord is also one of those heroes that benefits from a whole wide range of extension and optional items, depending on the game situation. If you need to disarm somebody, Heaven's Halberd's a great option. If you lack catch, you can go with Rod of Eidos. You can even use a Yule's BKB if you're getting really into the mix with a lot of magic damage. You know, if you need to dispel something or reflect, Lotus Orb. If you want to just be an absolute nightmare in the middle of the fight and just keep your magic, keep your stuff going, you know, Eternal Shroud. Long story short, he has so many fantastic options, one of the best offlaners in the game, and I actually have done a complete beginner's guide on him as well, which I'll link up above for those interested in checking that out. One of the reasons why I absolutely love it when DPC is back in town is we get to see some non-typical heroes in support roles. We saw during TI10 that Monkey King 4 was getting popular, and it kind of waned off a little bit after TI, and now it's back with the DPC winter season, and it is being done to tremendous effect. But it's also a very challenging position for hero, so I'm going to give that a little bit of a warning. I know a lot of players that watch this stuff are relatively new to the game, beginners, and people trying to, you know, figure themselves out. A challenging position for. You are taking talents that are fully into the support. You're building towards Jingu Mastery in the early laning stage so you can kind of harass. Boundless Strikes, you can lock down a kill. And then you're going Tree Dance, you can scout. The thing with him, though, is that the main item progression is basically identical. You're basically going to go these starting items into this here. It's what happens after that kind of is where, like, your experience playing Monkey King 4 is going to have to come into play. From Brown Boots, do you go Tranquil Boots? Do you go Phase Boots? If you want to be more aggressive, you go Phase Boots. If you're going to be moving around the map more, scouting, and if there's, like, you know, enemies that kind of require you to heal up more, like a Bloodseeker, you're going to be going Tranquil Boots. Are you against a Slark, a Clockwork, etc., a Forestaff? Are you against a Troll Warlord? Are you against a Legion Commander where you need Yul Scepter to help kite them? Does your team lack catch? Do you need a Rod of Eidos? Do you want to be a ganker with an Orchid of Malevolence? I barely even said that correctly. Are you mixing in the fights with a BKB? Do they have lots of spellcasters for a Mage Slayer? He is one of those position 4 heroes that can borderline build any of the support items, depending on the game situation. So that's why I kind of went through them quickly here, to give you kind of a quick idea. And if you're against really tanky Bristlebacks and Pudges and stuff, Spirit Vessel, right? But anyways, the complexity of position 4 Monkey King comes from the fact that he has near limitless combinations with items, so bear that in mind when you pick him for position 4. For position 5 hard support, Lion is seeing some play in the DPC Pro meta. Lion is a very popular hero amongst all players at all skill levels, but he's also one of those heroes that is really great for relatively new players because he provides a stun, a hex. He has a consistent presence with Mana Drain in the laning stage. He has a fantastic ultimate with Finger of Death. And overall, he's just an absolutely fantastic hero to play. And this build here, kind of, it's built around the idea of having a ton of fun with him in the position 5 and 4 role if you so choose. Basically, you're going to be building starting items to help sustain your lane. You are going to be moving towards, Tranquil Boots into Blink, Aether Lens, and the Aghanim Scepter. Ags, super greedy. But with this build, you're going movement speed into the Finger of Death health, into Finger of Death damage. You want to just be kind of murdering guys with Finger of Death. It's why you play Lion. It's the most fun thing about the hero. And from there, you have some extension items as well, depending on the game situation. If you're getting Dovahn by right-clickers like PA Wraith King, you go with like a Ghost Scepter. If you need to create space, Forestaff. If you need to kind of set up, if you want to actually move in on guys or disappear, or if you're against like Necrophoses and stuff like that, where you want that burst of magic resistance, Lina as well. Glimmer Cake, great item. But anyways, at the end of the day, right, what you're going to do is you're going to blink on top of someone, you're going to Earth Spike them, and then just before they're no longer stunned, you hex them, And then you finger them, death them, hopefully with the aid of your team. Aether Lens just simply allows you to kind of mix it up in team fights later on. But overall, one of the prototypical position 5 support heroes that are loved by so many. Thank you so much for watching, and a very special thank you to all of our wonderful subscribers. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments down below, and we'll see you in the next Dota 2 video.